ओके सो टुडेज लेक्चर इज अबाउट द बेसल फंक्शंस ऑफ सेकंड काइंड राइट इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव वी कंसीडर अ बेसल ऑर्डिनरी डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड वी फाइंड आउट द सॉल्यूशन वी कॉल बाय द सीरीज अप्रोच एंड वी कॉल दैट द फंक्शन एज अ बेसल फंक्शंस ऑफ फर्स्ट काइंड नाउ देयर एज आई टोल्ड यू एट दैट टाइम दैट दैट वी हैव आल्सो द बेसल फंक्शंस ऑफ सेकंड एंड थर्ड काइंड सो वी टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द बेसल फंक्शंस ऑफ second kind and do remember we also name them as Neumann functions so as you know jo Bessel's equation hai Bessel's ordinary differential equation the Bessel's equation is a second order linear homogeneous differential equation means that it has two linearly then it will have the two linearly independent solutions having two linearly independent having two linearly independent solutions okay now you know that we the last time we obtained a solution as j n x and the other solution correspond to n equal to minus n as j minus so these are the two independent solutions of the Bessel's equation now I told you at that time also that I will say that if I have some number nu is not an integer if nu is not an integer I told you this last time also these two solutions yani jo independent solutions linearly independent solution hai these two solutions can be chosen as like j nu of x and j minus nu of x so that is the case if nu is not an integer now if nu is equal to n is an integer limitations of series approach maine last time ye aapko bataya this is the repetition of the same thing now if nu is an integer that is equal to n and is an integer then this j n of x and j minus n of x are not linearly independent they are not linearly are not linearly independent I told you last time also j minus n of x is always equal to minus 1 raised to power n j n of x in that particular case so if n is an integer what could be the second solution then because since these two solutions j n of x and j minus n of x and I told you the reason also because the gamma factor in that denominator becomes zero becomes the gamma of a negative number and that is undefined right so the some terms yes. in the series will become zero so we cannot have a series expansion for the case when nu is an integer so the second solution in that case is given in this case is given by if nu is an integer is not an integer then we can have the series solution but if nu is not n is an integer then j n x and j minus x are not linearly independent the second solution in this case is given by like j n of x which I will obtain by the series approach ln of x plus summation over m running from 0 to infinity c m x raised to power m plus r also when we are talking about the Frobenius method And when we are trying to expand, find the serious solution of some equation which has a double root. I told you there also that the second solution is given by some y1 of x ln of x plus summation m running from 0 to infinity. Same is the case here. So if this n is not an is an integer, then the second solution will has a general form. The second solution is given by this particular thing. Now what I will do? Now I know that if one of the solution is known. So agar mere paas koi second order differential equation hai, like I have the Bessel ordinary differential, the Bessel ordinary differential equation like x square y double prime plus x y prime plus x square minus n square into y is equal to zero. This is Bessel's ordinary differential equation, right? Now what I am saying that to this particular equation, if one solution is known, the choice of the second linearly independent solution is not unique. Let me write it here so that you will also note down. If one of the solution, one solution is known, the choice of second linearly independent solution is not unique. Is not unique. यानी जो choice हम करेंगे for the second linear independent, that is not unique. It will not be unique. So what I will do then? So it is convenient. It is convenient to make a choice. To make a choice which is applicable to both the cases, which is applicable to both the cases. Which cases? When two cases, when nu is an integer and when nu is not an integer. So I will make a choice, the choice for the second independent solution, which will be applicable to both the cases, when nu is an integer and when nu is not an integer. So what could be the solution? So isi ko hum Neumann function bolte hain. So Neumann function n of x is defined as how we define as, this is what we call as a Neumann function, which is applicable to both the cases when nu is an integer and when nu is not an integer. So that choice is n nu of x is always given by cos of nu pi j nu of x minus j minus nu of x divided by sin of nu pi, right? You can name this as equation first. I will show you how this is the applicable for both the cases when nu is an integer and when nu is not an integer. So I will consider the first case. Case first is when nu is not an integer. What will happen? Since this j nu of x and j minus nu of x, you know that they are linearly independent, hai na? Abhi jo main shuru mein start maine hi se, if nu is not an integer, then j and x and j2x are the two solutions and are linearly independent, right? So j nu x and j minus nu are linearly independent. Therefore, so that means nu of x, that is a Neumann function, which is a linear combination of both j nu of x and j minus nu of x, is also linearly independent of, because it is a linear combination of these two functions, is also linearly independent of j nu of x. Also, you know that this j nu of x and j minus nu of x, yahan pe minus j minus nu of x are solutions, you know that they are solutions of what? Of Bessel's equation. Bessel's equation. We have obtained that they are solutions of Bessel's equation. So therefore, since Neumann function is a combination of these two, linear combination of these two, that means therefore, nu of x is also a solution of Bessel's equation. Is also a solution of Bessel equation. So what I consider, I'm just revising it and just repeating it all the things from the beginning. Then I will take the case second. I say that if I have this Bessel equation has two independent solutions, but those two independent solutions are corresponding to two different values of n. First case is when nu is an integer. If nu is not an integer or n is not an integer, we say that the jnx and j minus n of x are linearly independent solutions. But if nu is an integer, we cannot say that jnx and j minus nx are linearly independent. Then what I say? Then I say that the second solution will take the general form like ln of x, jn of x plus some series solution summation m running from 0 to r, 0 to infinity cm x raised power m plus r, right? While this is some expanding about some regular point. Is it okay? Okay. Instead of writing it separately for when n is not an integer and when is what I said, that I will make a choice which is applicable to both solution, both cases. Kon se hamare paas? When if nu is not integer and when nu is an integer. So for that case, this Neumann function is given by this very equation, right? This very equation. What does it suggest? It says that, so since why I say that nu is not integer, if nu is not the integer, then I say that jnx, then I know the case that jnx are linearly independent. Then also this nu of x is a linear combination. So it is a summation of these two things. So it is a linear combination of these two. So it is also linearly independent of jn of x. Also, we know that jnx and j minus, we have obtained it independently. They are the solutions of the Neumann, this Bessel equation. Therefore, that means that since Neumann function is a linear combination of these two, it means that the Neumann function is again also a solution to the Bessel equation. So this is the case one. Now the case second, is if nu is an integer. So what will be the case if nu is an integer? Okay. If, for example, here case, if nu is an integer, both numerator and denominator in equation, this above equation, in equation one are zeros. You know that sine of when nu is an integer, sine of 1, 2, 3, they are all, this is 0. 1 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, or minus pi, 2 pi, 3 pi. So this is 0. There is nothing to prove about it. But you know that cos of this numerator, cos of, I can say right, n nu pi j nu of x, I will write it here when nu is equal to n is an integer. So instead of nu, I will write here n and here also n, because I am considering this nu to be equal to n, jn of x minus j minus n of x. Okay. Can I write it cos of n pi? Cos of n pi is equal to minus 1 raised to power n, right? Because cos pi is minus 1, cos 2 pi is 1, cos 3 pi is minus 1. So depending on the value of n, j minus 1. Then jn of x minus, and j minus n of x, you know that is minus 1 raised to power n, j n of x. So this minus this will be equal to 0. So I show that this numerator is again, the denominator is itself a 0. So then, in order to get nu of n nu of x, so to get n nu of x in the case when nu is equal to n is integer, what I will do, we use L'Hospital's rule. And taking the derivative of numerator as L'Hospital's rule. So then this nu of x, n nu of x is given by, I will take the derivative of d by d nu of numerator term, that is cos of nu pi j nu of x minus j minus nu of x divided by d by d nu of sine of nu pi. Sine of nu pi. Is it okay? Is it okay up to this term?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if it is okay, then see how I can take the derivative of this thing. First, I will write down, then I will explain it term by term. I will write down this as 1 by pi. Yeah, let me do this. What will be the derivative of this cos of nu pi into j nu x? It will be cos of nu pi. I will take in out of this in the derivative and taking the derivative of this. So I will write down this as 1 by pi. Take common meaning one. Partial, taking the derivative of this j nu of x by d nu, partial nu minus, this is, I will write down this as minus 1 by raised power n j minus nu of x divided by partial nu when nu is equal to n. Okay, I will name this as equation second. Now try to understand this step, what I did here. This is cos of j nu. So I am taking cos nu out of the derivative. I will just do it separately here. I will write even this as cos of nu pi partial j nu by partial nu, right? Minus partial by partial nu of j of minus nu of x whole divided by cos of derivative of sine of nu pi, that is cos of nu pi into pi. Right, so this cos of nu pi, I am dividing it, so this will be 1 by pi. I am taking it out as, so this will be partial nu, partial j nu by partial nu minus, now cos of pi is also divided to this, so what I will write this as, I will write down here minus 1 raised to power n. So that minus 1 raised to power n, I will take it in the numerator, minus 1 raised to power n, 1 by cos of n pi, minus 1 raised to power n partial j minus nu by partial delta nu. So that is the thing I write it here. I take the separate differentiation of this terms, differentiation of this term, and divide it throughout by cos of this, the derivative of sine of nu pi. Is it okay? Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now if it's okay, then I will say that this value of n nu of x, I will write it again here, n nu of x, that is equal to 1 by pi partial j nu of x by partial nu minus 1 raised to power n partial j nu minus nu by partial nu at nu is equal to x. So I will show that this equation, this value of this nu of x it satisfies the corresponding Bessel equation. Yani I will substitute this value in the Bessel differential equation. If it satisfies the Bessel equation, this x square y double prime minus x plus x y prime plus x square minus n square into y is equal to zero. If it satisfies this equation, then I will say that this n nu of x given by this value is a solution to your differential equation. So I will say, how I will write down this differential equation. See, I will write down this Bessel differential equation as, I will write down this simply this as plus x square. Okay? D2j plus minus nu by d nu. Sorry, by dx2. Yani, or I can, ye equation mein aise bhi likh sakta hu na, x square into d2y by dx2 plus x dy by dx plus x square minus n square into y is equal to zero. So instead of writing y, now I have the two different solutions, j plus nu and j minus nu. instead of writing it separately, I am just combining both these equation. One equation will be corresponding to plus nu, and other will be, I will separate them later on. So I will say that, just one second. So from this very equation, how I will write down this equation as? From this equation, I will write down this as x square d2 by dx2 of y. Y mere paas jo hai, that is j plus minus nu, right? Plus, what could be the second term? X d by dx of j plus minus nu. Right? Okay. Plus, x square minus nu square, instead of n square, into y is equal to 0. What I will do now, I will just differentiate this equation with respect to nu. So when I am differentiating it with respect to nu, I will write it as x square d2 by dx2. So differentiate with respect to nu, will the differentiation will be for this term then. It will be partial by partial nu of j plus minus nu. Similarly, plus x into d by dx of Shabash, partial by partial nu of j plus minus nu plus x square minus nu square. So derivative of this y. So you should have a j plus minus nu, not y. J plus minus nu. So it will be partial j plus minus nu by partial nu. Shabash. I also have the term x square minus nu square. Its derivative is zero, but here it will be minus twice nu into j plus minus nu, right? J x square minus nu, j plus minus nu, because I have to take it the differentiation by parts. So this is equal to zero. You can name this as equation 4. Name this as equation 3. Ye zara band karo, shor hai na kahi pe. Okay. See, now these are actually two differential equations. One corresponds to j plus nu and the other corresponds to j minus nu. Instead of writing them separately, I write them jointly. Now I can just write them separately. What I will do, I will multiply the equation corresponding to j minus nu by minus 1 raised to power n. And I will do it separately. Multiply the equation corresponding to j minus nu by minus 1. Karo pehle wo cheez. So how I will write down this equation as? I will write down this as, the first equation as x square Shamash d2 by dx2, then partial by partial nu of j minus nu. And I will write down this minus 1 raised to power n here. Isko main multiply kar raha hu is equation ko, that is corresponding to this. Yeah, ab yahan pe likhiyega shuru mein hi minus 1 raised to power n. Similarly, plus minus 1 raised to power n x into d by dx of partial nu minus by partial x. Right? Plus, shabash, yahan pe minus 1 raised to power n x square minus nu square, ठीक है, j partial j minus nu by partial nu minus इसको भी minus one raised to power n minus one raised to power n minus one raised to power n twice nu j minus nu is equal to zero. This is equation 5. Do you understand it? What I am doing? This is a two equation corresponding to, these are two different equations. One corresponding to plus nu and other corresponding to minus nu. Now what I did, I just extracted from the minus nu wala jo equation hai, and I multiplied it throughout by x minus 1 raised to power n. So how I will write down the second equation? So that will be simply x square d2 by dx2 j. Oh, sorry, partial j plus nu by partial nu plus x d by dx of partial j nu by partial nu plus x square minus nu square into partial nu by partial nu minus 2 nu into partial nu is equal to 0. So name this as equation 6. Is it okay? If you have some if anybody has some doubt, he can raise his hand. He can raise his hand or he can unmute himself so that I will answer his question. Okay. So now I cannot move to the next page because I need both these equations here. For that case, what I will do, I will just rub these equations and I have to take the difference of these equations now. So our aim is to show that this new of x, jo humne value upar mein nikala hai, this is a solution to your differential equation, right? Okay. Now see, what I will do now, just subtract equation this 5 from equation 6. 6 minus 5. Subtract equation 6 from 5. Okay, so how I can do that? I have to subtract this from this. So there are two common terms, one common term x square and d2x. So I will write it in simple manner. I will write x square d2 by dx2 partial j nu by partial nu, this minus 1 raised to power n partial nu j minus nu by partial nu. Is it okay? Plus x into dx of this partial j nu by partial nu minus this term, minus 1 raised to power n partial j minus nu by partial nu. The third term, what will be the third term? X square minus nu square. X square minus nu square will be again common term. So partial j nu by partial nu minus 1 raised to power n partial j minus nu by partial nu. The last term will be minus, this will be 2 nu is common, 2 nu into j nu minus into minus 1 raised to power n j minus nu. Is it okay? This equation I subtracted from this particular equation and I write it down like this. So you can name this as equation 7. So in this particular equation, in equation 7, if we let nu tending to n and often multiplication throughout by and after multiplication by 1 by pi, we get. So if you have not to do it this to this particular equation, yani I'm just multiplying this equation by 1 by pi, this by 1 by pi throughout, this by 1 by pi and this by 1 by pi. So how I will write down this particular equation then? So then, because we have already defined this Neumann function for when nu is an integer, as I already do that. So what is that case? That was the, so if you remember, abhi jo maine humne find kiya tha, this n nu of x is given by 1 by pi partial j nu by partial nu minus 1 raised to power n partial j minus nu by partial nu. Jisko humne kuch equation naam rakha tha, equation 3 or something. So that is why, so I'm saying that if I will just let nu tending to n and multiply this throughout by 1 by pi. So you know that what will be this, what will be this, what will be this. So what will this equation become? It will simply now become x square d2 by dx2 of, so instead of 1 by pi nf, what I will write? N nu of x, or I will simply write n of x plus, so this thing. So it will be x d by dx of n of x, right? Plus x square minus n square, this thing will be equal to n of x. Is it okay? Now the last term will be gone when n, last term will be gone. So this last term I will cancel out, because for n equal to n, this term, this will be jn minus j, I will write down this minus 1 raised to power minus n, this and this will cancel out, it will be 0. So this will be equal to 0. So you see that this is very similar to what we had, the Bessel equations. So Bessel equation is like jo humne abhi kaha tha, x square d2 by dx2 and n of x, sorry, d2 by dx2 y plus x dy by dx plus x square minus n square into y is equal to 0. So we proved that from this equation that this n of x is a solution of n of x is a solution of Bessel's equation. So because it satisfies your Bessel differential equation, right? Is it okay? Unmute yourself. I'm taking some queries from you. If you have something to ask, you can. Because so we proved that this n of x is a solution to your what? Is a solution Bessel to your equation. Bessel.